Did you always want to be who you are today?
Someone very smart once told me a long time ago, let life happen because you don't really know what your gift is. Not me personally, I'm just saying the universal you. What your gift is, you have to allow things to happen. It's like, oh, wait, that's just something that I really like doing and I'm really good at it. And just stop trying to plan, because plans will get you into places that aren't necessarily where you're supposed to be.
Okay.
You have being open to whatever God, life, the powers, whatever you believe in, is set about for you, and finding what your gift is, and then exploring further how to make your gift be something that gives you passion and a sense of, like, I want to be alive. It gives you hope and challenge.
Yeah, but in your career and in your life,
I was like, a long time ago, I was like, I'm going to be an actress, and that's just all there is to it.
That's
this
right.
Teaching thing is like, that's for people who can't do, you know.
So how was life as an actor?
I found that when I was acting, the time would go by so slow. When I was on set, it would be like looking at my watch, like constantly going, God, it's like it seems like a minute would seem like an hour, you know. But then when I would teach, just initially the teaching was just like helping friends out, you know. That's what actors do; they help each other out. And I found the time would, you know, it's like went by so fast. So I realized time is like Einstein says, it's relative,
yes.
Right?
Yeah.
So my version of that is if you are interested and passionate and love something, it goes by really fast. If you don't love it, it goes by really slow.
It drags.
I determined that it was like, I really like the teaching part so much. And I also always loved writing. Now, writing is a very interesting thing because initially, and I've never told this story before, so you get this out of me every time. I always tell stories I've never told. But anyway, I was such an abused kid, so much so that it was verbal and physical, that I felt that anything I had to say was too stupid, and everybody was predisposed to hate me. So the only way that I could make people, like, just to have any kind of version of a relationship, because I couldn't utter a word, I'd have to do a countdown to say hello. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, hello. It's the only way I could get hello out, and that's as far as it went. But I would write funny stories and funny poems, and people would laugh because I would pass them along, because it was like I was mute. But I would pass them along, and they'd say, oh, you're really funny. Like, thank you. You know?
Okay.
But so writing became a thing that helped me actually communicate in a way that I had no way to communicate because I was so damaged by childhood issues.